Hi, this is Gene Moles. I've been around since Dead Sea died, but I wanted to put down a little autobiography. Some of my friends wanted this, and here it is. I'm up in years at this time, but I'm not going to mention when it is. It was about the year of... Anyway, I first started my career in music in 1947, my first professional job. Pretty green behind the ears at that time at the Paris Garden in Selma, California. Then I got a job in 1949 at the Blackboard, of all places, in Bakersfield. That was one of the biggest thrills then at my time. And then after I played at the Blackboard for about a year, I went to the Lucky Spot on Edison Highway. And played there for about almost 10 years. And then we got into 1960, and Merle Haggard was hired to play bass with our group for about 2 years, six nights a week, there at the Lucky Spot. And I recorded about four or five of his first songs. And then later in the 60s, I moved up to Tacoma, Washington. I met a guy by the name of Noki Edwards. He was the lead player for the Ventures rock and roll instrumental group. So I'd written some songs, instrumentals about that time, and I was asked to do six songs on the Venture album. And two of those pieces were my own writings, Sunny River and Gringo. And so in the 60s, my friend Red Simpson, Gene, he said, I'd like to use you on record at Capitol Records. So I went to Capitol, and I thank him to this day that he got me started actually in the country recordings. And the 60s was my heydays, believe me. I recorded with such artists as Jody Miller, cut an album, and I'd cut, of course, on Buck Owens' first record in 1959. I'm backing up there at Capitol Records. And then I cut on Merle's, of course, as I mentioned earlier, but this was later after Buck's. But then I recorded for Dick Curlis, Kay Adams, a truck album. It was the Little Pink Mac with her, Red Simpson, a Roll Truck Roll, and about four albums I cut with Red. The one was a police album. It was a tribute to the Highway Patrol. And so I recorded on that. And then so many sessions I did for Pat Buttram, and then I recorded to RCA, done my own writings, Durango and Scottish Guitar, and on and on and on. I could keep talking, but I'll kind of cut this short so your ears won't get too irritated listening. But anyway, on through the 60s, then I had played on television. I'll back up to 1953. Now this gets to TV. I played on a Jimmy Thomason show about 1 week before Cousin Herb's show went on Channel 10. This on 29 out on the hill. And I worked there till he ran for state senator, and he had to give up the show to run for state senator. And then later, there's others. I played on Cousin Herb's show in 1959 and 60. And then later, another gentleman moved to Bakersfield named Dave Stonger, and I played on his TV show. Billy Myers had a TV show, I played on his. Jelly Sanders had a TV show, I played on his. And then in the 60s, in the mid-60s, Jimmy Thomason started back his television show on Channel 23. And had great sound and everything. But that was on his show. And then I had an opportunity to go with the Everly Brothers, but my wife was pregnant back then and ready to give birth, so I didn't want to go on the road. And on and on. Right to this day, my materials that I've written, I'm getting residuals from foreign royalties, Japan. Oh, I won't name all the places, there are too numerous. All over the world there, other than the U.S. But I still get those, and I'm very pleased that I did those things back in those days. And we're doing a thing at Buck Owens Studio today, and I hope to see you there, whoever you will be. And thank you, and I'll see you later.